Our obsession with light skin has been around for centuries. In later interpretations of the Varna system, during the time of Bhrigu, skin color became a distinguishing factor of caste. Brahmins were described as white skin, while Shudras were known to have black skin. Though there is no evidence of skin color-based discrimination by the Mughals, they were a homogeneous group of lighter-skinned rulers. So light skin became synonymous with the superiority of the rulers, which was strengthened by other conquerors like the Portuguese and the French. But discrimination based on skin color became prominent during British rule. Black Indians were denied entry into restaurants and educational institutions. Though this formalized discrimination is long gone, fair skin has become entrenched as a marker of a person's social status. Advertisements for beauty products offer lightening, brightening, and glowing skin as something that would impact a person's job prospects, status, and visibility. Fairness creams are such a necessity that Indians spend more on fairness creams each year than on Coca-Cola or tea. A survey found that 70% of men believe that fair skin would give them an advantage over others in securing a job, success at interviews, or finding a partner. Indian movies too reinforce this notion. Fair-skinned actors often make their skin artificially darker with makeup when playing lower-class characters. Off-screen, Kala Rang is shamed and demonized as poor, ugly, and dirty, adding another layer of insecurity and fueling the desire to escape the ill fate of being born with darker skin. Women have reported that just by lightening their skin by two shades, they experience higher levels of confidence. All this adds up to an individual and cultural obsession with fair skin that becomes a distinguishing part of a person's beauty and social worth. It's the one aspect of our social status that we think we can easily change when it comes to our place in the world. But here's the thing. No amount of haldi, chandan, or skin lightening creams can actually lighten the color of our skin. So instead of buying into this myth and continuing to perpetuate it, maybe it's time to reject this discriminatory thinking altogether. And this rejection goes beyond dropping the fair in fairness cream or boldly claiming that dark is beautiful. It means attacking the social conditioning that tells us colorism is a natural preference and not a systemic bias. So that's all for this week's Overthinking It series. If you enjoyed this video, then don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the Swaddle. And to continue to overthink with us, hit the bell icon to stay updated.